everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we are springing our muscles and moving mulch. A couple of months ago, we made the decision, which was very hard, and some of you may remember our video, to have two of our biggest trees on the lot taken down. They were 50 feet tall maples, and they were lovely trees, but both of them were leaning because of trees that had been here when they were growing. And the one was right over the gas line that leads to the house. We didn't want to take a chance that that tree might fall over because we've had some windstorms, especially last summer. And also because both were leaning, we have high tension electrical lines across the street. So we had our team, Eduardo's Tree Service, come over, take them down. And as a result, we have a beautiful mulch pile.
We have two mountains.
Yes. For the time being, we're going to take what we're picking up off the lawn, put it in the wheelbarrows, and in the near future, we'll be bringing out the chipper, and we'll chip that up and add it to the mulch. As we were raking away and uncovering things under some of the sawdust from the trees, we found this leftover ice. Back in the olden days, before refrigeration, they used to take blocks of ice from the lakes and the rivers, put them in a storage bin, cover them with sawdust, and they would last almost the whole summer. Then people would The delivery trucks would go and get the ice, take it to people's house, and that's why they called them ice boxes back in the day instead of refrigerators.
That's what your dad delivered.
He did. He worked for Wisconsin Ice and Coal, and they delivered ice. As we were raking, look what we found. These are the maple tree buds that, even though we cut them down over a month ago, they're still going strong. So for the fun of it, we'll just take the end, strip it down, stick it in some root hormone, and put it in a pot and see if they'll turn into their new trees, and then we can plant those trees.
Cloning our maples. How are you going to talk with your mouth full?
I'm not telling you.
You're still chewing? After all these years?
All right, we're going to start filling the wheelbarrows. We're going to only fill them halfway. Not only because this is our first actual physical exercise of the season, but because we just know that we need to take it easy at the beginning especially. And we'll be happier if we don't ruin ourselves the first day. Hi-ho.
Hi-ho. It's off the boat we go.
I told you we were having company that's going to help us. Now, some of you from long ago may remember Logan when he was about 4 years old, maybe maybe younger. And every now and again, he comes over when we need his muscles, and we definitely need his muscles now. Thank you, Logan.
Oh, anytime. What happened to our other wheelbarrow?
Oh, yeah, well, we lost one of our wheelbarrows already because the tires wouldn't hold any air. So we had to take the tires off, take them to the hardware store, and they have to put new inner tubes in them.
Did she tell you the real story of why we only have one? She is a very aggressive woman. She put the pitchfork through both tires.
I did not. Here's my witness.
No. You weren't here when she did it. How can you be a witness? Watch out for this woman, I tell you. Anyhow, the goal is just to try to get as much of this off the grass as possible. So, you know, if we can do kind of a circle today, that'd be wonderful. If you guys filled it, I'll move it. You know, I feel like one of those city supervisors where you have 8 supervisors watching one guy work.
Yeah. We think of you that way, too.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, let Logan take it. And you will.
I need to, I
you
know
spread.
Where it needs to be dumped.
Well, you can tell him because you're going to be over there spreading.
Oh, this is so heavy.
Richard.
What?
Next time you might want to. Have you done the scooping with the shovel, Logan?
Yeah.
Maybe we can get some of this out of here.
You don't know what I had to go through last year. This is nothing.
Where? At?
Yeah. They gave me a huge pile. They're like, okay, get as much as you can. I was like, they're like, we're leaving for the day. I'm like, oh. See ya. Yeah.
Can you wait until they start the deck?
Oh, God.
I know.
I'm going to go to Maui. I'll be back in a couple of weeks.
Well, I'll be there. Okay.
That's Jared.
Is it?
Yeah.
Cool.
I knew the address of the thing over there.
Excellent.
I have to put more than 4 in at a time, though.
4 what?
4 little pieces.
Listen, don't talk to me when I have a pitchfork in my hand.
I know. This is the last wheelbarrow we have.
You guys should have told me, I could have brought over mine.
I know.
Well, I mean,
if you have mulch, they will come. Look at that. You didn't even get 2 pieces in.
I couldn't help it. It didn't stay.
2 little puny pieces of mulch.
You see how,
at that rate, we'll be here.
I'm treated around here.
Oh, boy.
It's a nice day out today.
Beautiful.
Gorgeous out, yes.
Yeah,
look,
I'm Rick.
More help.
This is Lynn, my wife.
You're on
I'm
video.
Jared.
Yes, you're on video.
Yeah, you too.
So you can spew your words of wisdom.
Or just grab this wheelbarrow and put it over where he wants it. Let Jared do it.
Well, I'll show you what we're doing.
Alrighty.
Thanks for coming.
Yeah. I used to do landscaping all the time.
Did you?
Well,
thanks.
Can't believe we got Logan out of his house.
We were just reminding people how they had seen him when he was like 2 and 3 and 4 years old.
Putting me on YouTube. See, now I could never like go off the face of the earth.
Yep, now you're on YouTube.
Well, and my mom decides to tag me in every Facebook post.
Oh. Your mom tagged me in her Instagram post.
Yeah.
I'm like, how'd she even find my Snapchat on my Instagram?
Oh, she has to wait.
Yeah, stalking.
Oh, let me count that. 1.
Oh,
1.
Watch it.
Garden abuse. Oh, not in my face. Some kind of a nut.
Yes.
Look at that.
It won't stay on my floor.
Look at that. Puny.
I can't help it.
Puny.
Well, they cut 2 trees down. So
this is just the mulching trees.
Plus, there was a big truck that came by that's working down in the neighborhood and asked if we wanted more.
Sure.
Why not?
Yeah,
you guys can put it somewhere. I got the two-wheel wheelbarrow. I hate the single ones now.
Yeah. It's spoiled. Well, we've moved probably almost 100 wheelbarrows of mulch, thanks to Sky, and then for a while...
Sky.
I'll take the credit.
You've gone very much younger. Logan. And his friend Jared came over and helped, and we probably moved about 10 feet into this pile, which is amazing, and found ice and snow that's been buried under there. So we're done for today.
Well, you don't want to overdo it.
No, we don't.
Any words of wisdom?
Look what's left.
Yeah. You know, when I walked, came down the driveway, I looked at it and it looks like we didn't do anything.
Yeah.
From that perspective.
From that side.
Yeah.
Yep.
It's amazing.
So this one last barrel is going to go over there and then we're done for today. There you go. Look at that. Love it. As you can see, we've been working. So we got rid of all of that over here on the grass. Just wanted to let you know that yesterday we were busy. This is what's left of our big two piles. Still a lot to move, but we have places for it. And you can see by the newness of the mulch, this is where we have moved it to so far. This is that first pile that was so large. And we've moved it now over to here between the driveway and the orchard. And you can see exactly where we stopped. What a difference. Now we will also be putting mulch along here, and we have just begun putting mulch over here in our native gardens. A lot of work, but it's going to be nice when it's done. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. We truly appreciate that. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, please subscribe over here. And then don't forget to hit that little bell up there so you're notified when a new one comes along, because I think there'll be some more. Thanks to all our helpers, and that's enough now. Time for some Tylenol and some rest. And Logan will head on home and take a nap.
Yeah, nap time. Nap time for me. Exhausted.
Well, thank you. Appreciate
it.
Connect with us on YouTube.